good morning. It's like 6:30, up and out of camp. There's probably, I don't know, 10 people there or so at the Doc's Knob shelter. So we had a good crowd, hadn't seen that many people in a long time. It's kind of weird, like when you the first day out of town or something, or I guess the last day going into town, it's like you run into all the people that have been on trail. But the people definitely get kind of spread out, I guess, once you've got like a gap where there's a couple of days worth of hiking in between. But anyway, we only got like 8 miles or so getting to Parrisburg today. It's a little bit of rocky, terrain for this morning. Depending on how rocky it is, if I'm fast enough, I can get into town and maybe get breakfast, but I don't know, we'll see. And I think the last mile or two into town is going to be one hell of a descent, because we're up on the ridge all day until right at the end, and we get this huge descent into town. So that might slow us down too. It's cool seeing Walmart again. A lot of people that are staying here, we're all going to head into town, do everything we need, kind of all got the same game plan. We're all going to go to, most of us will be at the Angel's Rest Hiker Hostel. So should have a good crowd there. This is just something of note, but when I was hanging my food bag last night, it only weighed probably like 6 ounces because I've got just a half day's worth of granola bars and stuff in it. But I hoisted it up the tree, and then I got the stick. I was doing the PCT style hang. And then I go to lower the bag back down, and it wouldn't come down because the bag was too light. So after some finagling, I finally got it to come back down. I had to load it up with like 2 pounds of rocks before I was able to get it at a good weight. I was able to go up and down more smoothly. So just of note, don't hang a light food bag. You might get stuck up in the tree. I'm up on the top of the ridge, just came out to an area where these power lines cut through. Finally get a view this morning, and what a view it is. This is one of my favorite kinds of views. You just got this sea of clouds going on. Run over to the other side of the ridge too and get some shots over there. And here's out to the west. This would be like a cool camping site. Like a little stealth spot or something. Maybe somebody was here last night. Grass is all tamped down. Into the big rocket descent now down to Parrisburg. Here's kind of a side view trail from, I think this is actually called Angel's Rest or Angel's Rest Rock or something like that. There's Parrisburg. Yeah, as expected, this is a really gnarly descent. It's very steep, and there's bits with tons of rocks and stuff. This is much better going down it than it would be coming up it. Gotta love these long descents. We're very close. Very close to the bottom. Alright, I got picked up from the trail. We're all checked in. Angel's Rest Hiker's Haven. This place is awesome. I've already got a good shower, got laundry cooking up real quick. We just got a pizza ordered. Be digging into that real fast. And then I got to do all the logistical planning to see what the next stretch is going to look like. I think it's only like 100 miles to Daleville. That might be the next town we're going to stop into. And there's a grocery store just down the way, and we'll be able to get all the food and everything there. But for right now, let's dig into some pizza. Here's just a quick shot of what the bunk room looks like. Like a pretty nice setup. G and Bill have just arrived, so they're gonna get a shower going and figure out food options and whatnot. I just got done figuring out my next leg of my trip, so let's take a look at my phone here. All right, so there's where we got off, route 100. We're in Harrisburg. I try to get breakfast before we head out, so maybe just a 13-mile day. Maybe some campsites, looks like the nearest option there. And then almost a 19-mile day to get to the next shelter, and then bounce to another shelter. There's a road crossing here. There's another hostel, Four Pines. The reviews on Four Pines were kind of mixed. It's like a donation-based place, and a lot of comments were like, well, you get what you pay for kind of place. So very basic amenities type there, but I can get some resupply done. And then from there, it's only another day and a half. We get another shelter, and then we'll get into Daleville, will be the last spot. And then reviews there says stay at the Super 8, so I think that's what I'm going to plan on doing. So what is that, like a four-day stretch, get in, resupply, and then it's just a day and a half. So that's what the next go-around looks like. All right, we just got back from a quick Walmart resupply, and I've done some initial calculations, and it looked like a four-day trip to the first resupply point, so that's all I've got here. Kind of a 3.5 day really, but I think I'll have enough until we get to a little grocery store along the way we might be able to resupply at. So I've got a lot of bars and stuff. This is going to be breakfasts and lunches, and then for the dinners I'm doing again the instant mashed potatoes and throwing in some tuna creations packets for that. So that's just a quick resupply right there. All right, so back in Marion, I ordered myself new shoes, so they have arrived just in time for here. I'm using the same as what I've currently got, the Salomon Speed Cross 5s, brand new. I'm gonna swap the new insoles and put those in there, and I think they should definitely be an improvement over what I got. So right now I'm at mile 630-something, and I had about 100 miles of wear already on my shoes, so they're already 700-plus for my old pair. So the old pair is going in the trash, got the new pair ready to rock. All right, we're done with our Mexican dinner restaurant. That was really good. Now we're over at the Dairy Queen for some ice cream. The inside is closed, so we're just huddled in the awning on the side of the building eating our ice cream, but this'll work. All right, I'm gonna go ahead and end the day right here. Yeah, Angel's Rest Hostel is awesome. This place is totally cool. Plenty of room for extra tents and stuff. We got a really good setup here. Got all my resupply and stuff done for the next push. And we've got a good full belly of some good town food and everything. Ready to rock for the next adventure into the woods. Thanks for watching. See you guys tomorrow. Good morning from Harrisburg. We are up and out of the Angel's Rest Hostel. That place is awesome. Highly recommended. We got a pretty good setup going on. Good clean hot showers and all that good stuff. So we've got our new shoes on. Shoes are doing really good this morning so far. We'll get a little chance to break them in today. And we're dropped back off at the trailhead where we started yesterday, or where we ended yesterday. There was rain and stuff last night, a little bit this morning. We got a break in the weather right now. I think we're supposed to have a break for a couple of good hours, but then since like starting around noon, 1, 2 o'clock, that kind of thing, it's gonna be lots of rain all night. So today rain, tomorrow rain, I think, maybe the next 2 or 3 days, and then it's supposed to be back to being like sunny and stuff. Which would be fun, right about the chance, right about the time that we're expected to be setting up a tent on a ridge, we'll probably be in the rain. It's not supposed to be windy and stormy, I don't think, just raining. So if it was super windy, I'd definitely be looking for other options than trying to tent up on a ridge line. We'll have to play it by ear though. Crossing over the New River as we leave town. A deer up ahead on the trail checking me out. There's a ton of deer out here this morning. So far it's been a pretty nice gradual uphill. It's just gonna be a long uphill out of town. Well, I'm about a half a mile before the first shelter for today, Rice Field Shelter. And I think this is gonna be the one and only water source for the entire day. So I'm gonna have to load up here, drink a lot. It's gonna be about a 7 mile, 2 liter water carry. Made it to the top of the ridge. Now it's all ridgeline walking for the rest of the day. That was a long uphill. It wasn't bad, it was just long. And also, it looks like a shelter over there. That must be the rice field shelter. We're gonna skip that one. We just had our lunch break at the water source. So we're just gonna keep going on. I think it's like another 7 or so miles till we'll hit some stealth sites. Bill's a little bit ahead of me, so me and him are gonna stick to the same game plan together. So he'll be scouting out the sites ahead and seeing what's good. I might already see him set up when we get there. Now that I'm up on this ridge, I think this might be the area where I was thinking where that ice storm happened, because there's a lot more stuff like this with the broken limbs. You can see a lot of stuff's been cleared out. I think this was a massive effort, all hands on deck kind of thing, to power lines had to be repaired up here, and just all the downed trees had to be cleared. The trail itself was closed for I think over a month or so, back in February through March. So thanks to everybody who had a hand in cleaning this up, as I'm sure it was a nightmare. Now I think this is the area where the entire power line tower had to be repaired and replaced. So I think this is a brand new tower, either this one here or the next one down the line. I just can't imagine how much of a project this would have been. This place was totally destroyed. But some of this, I think this fencing on the left side here might be some of the temporary fencing that the work crews were trying to do to try to get the trail open earlier, but it stayed closed for a while because even after the towers were rebuilt, they had to clear all the trees and stuff out of the way. There's a deer and a little baby fawn just right in front of me, maybe 75 feet. They were hiking down the trail a little bit ahead of me. Moving off to the left a little bit. I don't know if we can see him. I can see the mother still. There's the little baby. There's the little one. Oh, looks like I caught back up with Bill, so we're heading out together. And yeah, you can definitely tell that every tree in this area is just bent over or snapped in half. You can just imagine what a mess this would have been to clean up. It's just this miles and miles of it, this on this ridgeline. It's just destroyed by that storm. So again, a big thank you to all the trail crews, everybody that had a hand in cleaning this up. Thank you, thank you, thank you, because this looked like it had been a project and a half. Well, we got rained on for like an hour straight, but we're good now. At least it's warm and wet is way better than being cold and wet, so it's not that bad. The area needs more rain anyway. Okay, here's just a quick update. So originally we were gonna plan to do like 13 whatever miles till we get to some campsites on the ridge, but due to the rain, just because it sucks, you know, setting up tents and taking down tents and stuff in the rain, the next shelter is only like a further 5 miles from those campsites, so we've decided to push on to the next shelter. And we're just gonna have kind of a big descent going into there for the last like 2 miles or so, but our legs and everything are still feeling good, so we're skipping the campsites and moving to the shelter. And that'll make today like, I don't know how much miles exactly, but close to like a 19-mile day, I think. And then we may change up the plan for what we're doing for tomorrow, or we may just make tomorrow like a 12-mile day or whatever the difference turns into, because tomorrow was gonna be a big day. Anyway, we'll figure it out later, what we're feeling. G was doing a southbound slack pack back to the hostel, so we ran into him. But we'll catch back up with him tomorrow, and we'll just kind of refigure out what our game plan's gonna be. We've got 2.5 miles left to the shelter. This is the split off where Allegheny Trail is at. And from here, I think it'll be all downhill, potentially steep, but that'd be fine, because we've been going like uphill all day for the last like 17 miles. And we're done for the day. Here's the shelter, Pine Swamp Branch, and my feet are tired. Here's what the inside of the Pine Swamp Branch shelter looks like. It's a very similar design to that odd one we saw a couple of weeks ago, it seems like. Fire pit in the middle. It's got that upper bunk that's really small and tight, so I'm tucked up on there. Be nice and cozy. Luckily, we got here right before it started raining, right as we were cooking dinner and stuff. We had a good downpour for another hour or so, but it's let up again. Probably do that intermittently throughout the tonight and tomorrow again, as usual. I think it's supposed to be kind of intermittent rainy. Kind of shelter hop again to the whatever our next destination is going to be. We'll figure that out tomorrow. But I'm going to sign off here, get tucked in for the night, try to go to bed early, I think. Gotta probably have a long day hiking. We'll figure it out, though. I'll sign off for now. Thanks for watching. We'll see you guys in the next one.